Hello everyone and welcome to another Laptop Tech Tips video. Today we'll be talking about laptop processors or CPU. It's more confusing to buy a laptop compared to a desktop system. Also, there are a lot of variations. So today I'll simplify the laptop processors line for beginners and help you understand which laptop processor you should buy for gaming, video editing and other professional work. This video is mainly for beginners and I'll try to make an advanced one later on. With that being said, let's get started. First of all, what processor you need depends completely on what you're going to do with it. Generally for laptops, high-end CPU models come with high-end other parts as well. Like desktop, you can't choose the parts individually. For start, if you're an average Joe who surfs the internet, write documents, watch movies, listen to music and do a few other basic things, then AMD A series, Intel Pentium, Celeron and Atom series is for you. These processors are very cheap and come with cheaper laptops. They are power efficient as well. Laptops with these processors usually come with 2GB of memory, which will be enough to carry out your daily work. But of course, 4GB would be a better choice. Laptops with these CPUs will be able to carry out your day-to-day tasks. Now let's come to the mainstream users. For mainstream users, AMD has the A series processors or APUs and Intel has Core i3, Core i5 and Core i7. Say you are going to do the basic tasks and do a bit more like photo editing on Photoshop and a little more CPU intensive work, then Intel Core i3 would be for you. They'll get most of the job done for an average user who does a bit of work like photo editing, designing and a few other CPU related tasks. Also make sure to get 4GB of memory for a better experience. A Core i3 laptop CPU is a dual core processor with hyper-threading. It's weaker than a desktop Core i3 but gets the job done for most people. Now let's move on to the people who will look to spend a few more bucks and look to do a bit of gaming and other CPU intensive tasks like video editing, 3D modeling, rendering, video encoding and decoding, compression and depression, then you should get a Core i5 at least. A 4th, 5th or 6th gen i5 will get most of these tasks done. I'm still using an Intel 4th generation Core i5 laptop and I have done pretty much everything mentioned earlier. Laptop Core i5s are much weaker compared to desktop Core i5s. Almost every mobile Core i5 CPU is a dual core with hyper-threading just like a laptop Core i3. The only difference is it comes with higher clock speeds than a laptop Core i3 processor. Sadly, most laptop Core i5s has dual cores with hyper-threading while the desktop counterparts have 4 logical cores. If you're looking to play games, then make sure you have a decent GPU alongside the Core i5 processor. GPU is the most important part in a gaming build. A Core i5 laptop without a decent GPU will struggle to run the latest games even at lowest settings. Make sure you get an at least AMD 8750M or R9 M360 or GTX 940M if you're looking to game on it. As far as professional video editing is concerned, a laptop Core i5 gets the job done but it takes a lot of time to render and it's better to move on to a Core i7. Yes, you can get the job done but you won't be happy with the performance you're going to get from a laptop Core i5 CPU as far as video editing is concerned. Make sure to get at least 4GB of memory and 8GB is recommended. Finally, if you're a hardcore gamer who is looking to play all the high graphical games at decent settings and decent frame rates or looking to do professional video editing comfortably, then it's time you move on to a mobile Core i7 CPU. Usually, mobile Core i7 CPUs have 4 cores and has hyper-threading. These laptop mobile CPUs will be able to handle intensive tasks like gaming at high settings with decent frame rates. If you're a professional video editor, then you should look to get an i7 with at least 8GB of memory. 16GB of memory will help in editing as well. Laptop Core i7 CPUs will give you a lot more performance compared to a laptop Core i5 CPU. But the Core i7 mobile CPUs are much weaker compared to the desktop counterparts as well. But it will get the job done for most professional work including video editing, compression and depression, 3D rendering and finally gaming. If you are not a gamer, then a Core i7 CPU alone will be enough for you. Of course a GPU will help in rendering but the CPU alone would be decent enough. But if you're a gamer, then a decent GPU is a must. A Core i7 mobile CPU without GPU will struggle like a Core i5 to run latest GPU intensive games even at low settings. But combined with a decent GPU like a GTX 960M or GTX 970M, you can get a decent gaming performance and play most games at high settings at decent frame rates without a problem. Also, you should consider getting at least 8GB of memory along the CPU and the GPU. Also, when considering the Intel processor generations, it's better to choose the newer ones as they are more power efficient, resulting less heat and powerful compared to the older generations. But if you are that much serious about gaming and professional work, then I would highly recommend you to get a desktop. A desktop Core i5 or Core i7 is a lot better compared to the laptop counterparts. You should definitely look to get a desktop Core i7 if you're really looking to do some professional work. Also, this video is only for beginners and I tried to keep it as simple as possible. I'll be doing an advanced one in the future. I hope this video helps you in understanding laptop mobile processors better and which processor or CPU will be able to fulfill your needs. If you find it helpful, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe for more laptop tech tip videos like this. I am AbsTechie and see you later.